and welcome to Community Living Room at Home. I'm Sharon and today I'll be teaching you how to make one of these lovely lampshades in just a few straightforward steps. For a small amount of fabric, you can make one of these beautiful lampshades that can add a bit of personality to your home. What do you need to make a lampshade? Well, the easiest place to start is to buy a kit online. The kit contains a piece of laminate PVC. It's specially made and it's a bit like some sticky black plastic. That provides the rigidity to your lampshade. You also receive a ring set. There are two rings, a plain one and a one which is called a gimbal. The gimbal is where your light fitting goes. If you can imagine, if it's a ceiling lamp, the gimbal goes at the top. If it's a table lamp, it goes at the bottom. So these kits are flexible. You can make a lamp tuned for anywhere in your house. Also, is some double-sided sticky tape. I'll show you what we use that for later. And a magic little tool. Again, come back later and we'll find out how to use that. What isn't included in the kit is your choice of fabric. Any kind of fabric can work as long as it's not too heavy. So some dressmaking cotton, some quilting cotton, or even a medium weight curtain fabric. Choose a piece that you like. The other things that you need, a pair of shears for cutting your fabric and a pencil. That's it, let's get going. Today I'll demonstrate how to use the kit, but if you do buy a kit, there are really comprehensive colour pictures that guide you through each individual step of lampshade making. This is really, really useful. Let's make this lampshade. Today I'm going to show you how to make a 20cm diameter lampshade. It's one that's this size, so it's 20cm diameter and 18cm tall. Perfect as a ceiling lamp in a small room or as a table lamp. The first step is to decide where you would like to place your fabric. The fabric I'm using today has an all-over print, so it doesn't really matter where I place it. However, if you have a directional print with large features, you might want to make sure that you can see all of that piece. Position your laminate on top of the fabric and cut your fabric with about a 2-inch border all around. You then need to iron your fabric. Sorry about that, but it's really important that the fabric is super smooth with no creases. If there are any creases on your fabric, when it's made into a lampshade and you turn the light on, you will see every single crease. So iron, 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 and just check on both sides that it's completely crease free and there's no pieces of fluff anywhere. You then turn the fabric upside down and place your laminate on top. You want to place it so the short edge there is parallel to the self edge of the fabric. If you cut it at an angle, it will drape incorrectly around the lampshade. So just make sure it's nice and straight. When you're happy with the placement, you then draw around the laminate. Let's see, I'm going to position it so it runs along the top of those reindeer backs and it's still square there. Just get a pencil and lightly draw all the way around. This is just a guideline to help you later when cutting. Just draw around each side of your fabric to produce a faint guideline. It might be difficult to see, but there it is, our rectangle. The next step is to stick your laminate onto your fabric. See there, we have the corner. We peel back, this can be a bit tricky, about 10 centimetres of the paper backing. This is really sticky, this is the sticky side, we turn it over and we line up the corner of the laminate with the corner that we've drawn on. Like that, make sure we're happy. And then we press it down. And then with one hand on the laminate and your other hand underneath, you pull back the paper, making sure that you follow the line that you draw. So I'm pulling with my right hand and then just pressing it down with my left hand. Yeah, making sure that it's still lined up. Good, I'm happy with that. Just smooth it down to make sure there are no creases. If there are any creases, you can always pull it back and stick it back down. Now, get your scissors. Large dressmaking shears are ideal, but just any that you have. And we're going to cut right around the panel. Don't cut the plastic, but cut right next to the plastic. Always turn it around to make it easy to cut. If you're cutting at an angle or twisted, you won't cut nice and straight. If the fabric frays a little bit whilst you're cutting it, don't worry. Any loose edges, you can tidy up at the end. All of a sudden now, it begins to look quite small. And people often worry that it isn't going to make a lampshade of the right size. But it will. This will make a lampshade that finishes like that. And now you've finished the panel, we can go on to the rings. Now we'll prepare the rings by sticking some of the double-sided sticky tape all the way around. The tape is placed in the middle of the ring, just like that. It's not wide enough to wrap all the way around. We just need to stick it to the outside. And then when we complete the circle, just get some normal household scissors and snip the tape so the two ends meet up. Just like that. And then just go round and make sure that the tape is adhered to the ring. We do that on the second ring too. It's often easier with this ring if you start away from one of these struts. All the way around, pressing as we go. And then when we get back to where we've begun, again, household scissors, snip. The two ends meet and we press it down. Like so. Next, go back to your panel, and what we're going to do is peel off these strips at the top and bottom. The laminate is made with a tiny kiss cut. Just bend it over so we can peel off the excess at the top. Ah, I love that sound. And then carefully peel it off. You'll see some fraying. Don't worry, but just go with your finger, and if it frays too much, stop, put your finger down, just to minimise the fraying. That's one side done. I'll do the same on the other. Crease one way, crease the other way, and that just breaks that strip off, which we can now peel off. We've removed that strip from the top and the bottom, and the last piece now is to put some of your double-sided sticky tape along the right-hand side of your panel. This is what will help form the seam. So starting at the top of the fabric, just run a strip right next to the edge and tap it up at the bottom. So we have that strip ready to form the seam when we roll the lampshade. This is now my favourite part of lampshade making. We're going to turn this 2D flat object into a 3D lampshade just in front of your eyes. We've prepared the rings, we've prepared the panel, now we're going to put it all together. You need to decide at this point if you want it to be a table lamp or ceiling lamp. If you've got a pattern which doesn't have a direction, it doesn't matter. But with my reindeer, it would look a bit silly if they're upside down. So I'm going to decide to make this a table lamp, which means the gimbal needs to be at the bottom and the plain ring at the top. If it was going to be a ceiling lamp, the gimbal would be at the top and the plain ring at the bottom. So first of all, take the gimbal side and peel off the protective layer of your double-sided sticky tape. And just go around with your hands again, it's really sticky now, and make sure that it's nice and adhered to the ring. Then place that piece that way down. If you place it the other way down, it might stick to your table. Do the same on the other ring. Because it's a table lamp, the gimbal end is going to go at the bottom and the ring at the top. Place the ring right on the edge of the plastic, not on the fabric and not too far up, just right on the edge like that. And then place the other ring at the top, again not on the fabric, right on the very end. And then we take a deep breath and we start rolling. The tape grabs the laminate, as you can see, and right before your eyes it starts rolling. All the way along, keep checking that the ring is right at the edge of the plastic and not on the fabric. If you go a bit wrong, it doesn't matter. You can unpeel it a little bit, and because the wire is bendy, you can change direction. So you just roll. So I'm just checking that on both sides the ring is right on the edge. The further along the lampshade you go, it kind of starts to take care of itself. When we get near the edge, remember we need to create the seam. So peel off the red protective cover. There you can see the sticky tape. And I think it just helps if you bend down now. So I'm right on the edge of the white laminate. And then to form the seam, just continue rolling. Press down with your fingers right in the middle. And let's have a look. It's beginning to look a bit more like a lampshade now. I just need to run up and down this crease a little bit just to make sure that the two layers are stuck nicely together. The final step of making the lampshade is to roll the edges. As you can see, you've got the frayed edges here. What we're going to do is roll it over and under the wire. Let me show you how. First of all, where the struts are, just do a little snip about two-thirds of the way in. That just helps us wrap the fabric around. So we are wrapping the fabric over and under. It's not over and down, it's over and under. You want to be curling it round. You can just kind of do it a little roughly to start with. And this is where this tool comes in. This tool helps you push the fabric over and under. Start off with the zigzag edge and just use it to help push it under. Now this takes a little bit of time. You can just do it roughly to start with and then go to the straight edge, and that helps you push a little bit more. So I've worked roughly around that side because there's not much space between the ring and the laminate, and it's just squeezing the fabric in. But the more you can squeeze in and hide that fray edge, the neater and more professional your rolled edge lampshade will look. Okay, I'm nearly there with that side. As you can see, it's nice and smooth on the outside. You want it to be smooth on this side, smooth at the bottom, and any little creases are tucked away inside. Turn it over. There's obviously no gimbal, no struts on this side, so you don't need to do any little snips. You just work the fabric around. again. If it cracks, that's great. That shows that you're pushing it in really well. What I recommend you do is you take your time on this step. Go around several times. Just keep on looking for any little bits that you think haven't been tucked away and tuck them away. If you have any pieces that are fraying badly, don't worry about it. Just get some little scissors and snip those fray bits off. It won't affect the finished look of your lampshade and it just makes it look a little bit neater on the inside. So, the finished lampshade. I like the reindeer on it. I guess I could use it at Christmas, but because of the colour, it would really do any year round.